Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we will be learning about Egyptian architecture. This is HOA class number 2. So you might have watched class number 1. So in that class we saw timeline of architecture, which is very important according to Gates' perspective. Then we saw prehistoric architecture. So in prehistoric architecture we saw types of settlements that were used during the Stone Age men. We saw the three stages of prehistoric architecture. Then we saw Near East architecture, which was around 3500 BC. So you try to remember the time period also, like prehistoric was around 9000 BC and Near East is around 3500 BC. So let's start with Egyptian architecture today. So Egyptian architecture began with development around River Nile. So Nile was a basic source of water. It was basic source for agriculture. All the major trades that happened during that time were along the banks of River Nile. Okay, so Nile was of paramount importance to Egyptian people. And now we will look about various terms that are involved. Pharaoh is nothing but denotion of a king. Egyptian kings were known as Pharaoh. Society was divided into classes. Mainly there were three classes. So the first class men included noblemen, priests, army people, etc. The second class people included farmers, masons and laborers. And the third class people were prisoners, thieves, etc. Okay. So the basic term what makes Egyptian special was the term known as mummification. You might have seen in the movies. So mummification is nothing but after the a person was dead, the dead parts were removed, the body was dried and linen was marked and bandaged. Okay, and then it was put into a cask. Okay, so let's jump into the architecture part. So for Egyptian architecture, materials used were mainly limestone. Okay, limestone was the main material for Egyptian architecture. Then due to the scarcity of food, predominant materials were usually sun-dried mud bricks and stone also were used, but the main one was limestone. And they also used sandstone and granite in considerable quantities. Okay. So talking about the roofs were generally flat and with big opening as a skylight. Okay, so there were flat roofs for temples and all, for Egyptian temples, and with a skylight. Okay, so now let's talk about the walls. Walls were diminishing at the top, so the base was higher in width than the top, so it was diminishing at the top. So walls were unbroken and massive for hieroglyphics. Okay, hieroglyphics is the carving that can be seen on the Egyptian walls, pylons, etc. Okay, so decoration was mainly done using torus molding. So it was a kind of molding that was used. It is known as torus molding. So Egyptian used to write in a surface known as papyrus surface. Okay, it was a writing surface. You might have seen this type of structures all over Egypt. It is known as sphinx. Sphinx is nothing but it has a head of a man or hawk and body of a lion. Okay, it's known as sphinx. So it was the basic reason was that it was purpose of guarding the temples. Okay, then comes mastaba. Mastaba is nothing but a tomb. Mastaba is in a form of flat roofed. It is a flat roofed rectangular structure dome with inward sloping sides. So as in elevation, you will see something like this. Okay, it is flat roof and the slopes are inward. Okay, constructed out of mud bricks. It was mainly made of mud bricks. The another term comes is Sardab. Sardab is nothing but a chamber with a small hole. Okay, So as you can see in this picture, there is mastaba, okay, where there are underground burial chambers. A long shaft leads to it, and this is sardab. Sardab is nothing but a small chamber with a slit hole, so that it could allow the soul of the dead people to move about freely. Okay, it was their belief that soul of the dead people would move in that small slit hole chamber. So sarcophagus is the Egyptian coffin where the dead bodies are mummified and then put in that coffin. So that's known as sarcophagus. So going ahead, Egypt is famous for nothing but pyramid. Pyramid are massive funerary structures made up of limestone, bricks, and it is built in layers. The offering chapel of the pyramid is either in north or east. Okay. So pyramid, it is a triangular with a square or rectangular base. Okay. So stepped pyramid. Stepped pyramid, there are three types of pyramid. One is the normal that you can see here. Another is the stepped pyramid. It is very similar to ziggurat. Okay. The third one is bent pyramid of Senefeu. So bent pyramid of Senefeu has a special quality that its angles. See, I'll draw a perpendicular line from here. This degree is about 54 degree, and this degree is about 43 point something or 44. So the difference in the angle is 11 degrees. Okay. So there was bent pyramid of Senefeu. Pyramids are Gizeh are the multiple pyramids which are considered as a group of famous pyramids. Okay. Remember, Grand Gallery is present only in the Great Pyramid of Giza. The Grand Gallery, the Great Gallery is present only at the Great Pyramid of Giza. So let's talk about the temples of Egyptian people. The temple mainly consists of six parts, okay, six main parts. First one is pylon. Pylon is nothing but this entry tower. You can see it is the entrance gateway in Egyptian architecture. So there are many entrance gateways. There are many terms for example Japan. For Japanese architecture it is known as tori, okay. And for Egyptian it is known as pylon, and for temple there is gopuram. We will see about these terms later. So Egyptian entrance tower is pylon. Then we have a small colonnaded courtyard in here. Okay, then comes the hypostyle hall. Hypostyle hall is nothing but a hall whose roof is supported by columns. Okay. Then comes the second hall, also known as bark. Okay, then comes the sanctuary, and there is a sacred lake around here. So there are six main parts for an Egyptian temple. First one is pylon, second one is courtyard, third one is hypostyle hall, fourth one is the second hall, also known as bark, the fifth one is sanctuary, and the last one is sacred lake. So as you can see, pylon is nothing but the entrance gateway in Egypt. Also there is a tower, upright tower in front of pylon, which is known as obelisk tower. Okay, so obelisk tower has a square plan and it is tapering at the top. Okay, it is a square plan and it is tapering at the top. Okay, so height is 9 or 10 times the base. So if you have a square base, its height is 9 or 10 times the base. Okay, then four-sided hieroglyphics. The carvings are on all four sides of the obelisk tower. Then we have hypostyle hall. Hypostyle hall, we saw in Near East also that hypostyle hall was developed, but the main hypostyle hall was developed during Egyptian architecture. So it is a roof which is supported by columns. Okay. As you can see here, colonnaded roof and a hypostyle hall. Then there are three famous temples in Egyptian architecture. Temple of Amon Karnak. Okay, as you can see, pylon, hypostyle hall. there is a sacred lake. Okay, so this was the basic planning of Egyptian temple. So another famous temple is Temple of Amon Luxor and the great temple of Abu Simbel. Abu Simbel also known as Temple of Ramesses II because it was built by King Ramesses. Okay, so this fourth statue are of King Ramesses of height of 20 meters. Okay, so this was all about Egyptian architecture. So till now we have finished prehistoric, Near East and Egyptian architecture. So try to remember the timeline, it's very important. In GATE 2020 also there was an one mark question based on timeline. Okay, so when you remember the timeline, you can also remember the architecture styles. Okay, it's very easy when you remember it according to the timeline. If you just remember what is, for example, if you remember Christian, Gothic, Romanesque, so all will mix up in your head. But if you remember it according to the timeline, then it will be clear to you. Okay, so please learn the timeline first and then rest of the videos you can see and watch. Okay, so if you like my video, please like this, the like button, please subscribe to my channel. Okay, thank you very much, take care, bye.